Because it is. Because sometime tomorrow, the sun will expand and blow up, consuming Earth with its outer layers. Earth will be gone and we will be gone. So what do we need to do? We need to find a new planet. Maybe a planet that's less temporary, and maybe a planet that already has life on it. Because if other species can live there, then maybe we can too. Scientists have already started looking for other life in our galaxy, and just recently, NASA chief scientist Ellen Stofan made news by saying, "I think we're going to have strong indications of life within a decade, and I think we're going to have definitive evidence within 20 to 30 years." Scientists have already found moons, such as Europa, a moon that orbits Jupiter, that may have tidal interactions with Jupiter, causing an under-ice ocean. If Europa is being warmed, then because of the warmth, there is life. Warmth leads to melting ice into water, and all life as we know it needs water. This ocean is also shielded from radiation because of the outer ice layers, and has the three key ingredients of life: organic chemicals, water, and energy. It may also have underwater volcanoes, which would heat the water, providing warmth for bacteria. Other moons that may have life are Enceladus and Titan. Enceladus, one of Saturn's moons, may also have an ocean under ice. In 2005, Cassini spacecraft spotted ice and water vapor spewing from fractures near the moon's south pole. These geysers may spit out organic compounds, and over 100 of them were counted after photos from the Cassini spacecraft were analyzed. Most of them found in the Tiger Stripe region of the moon, which are subparallel linear depressions near the moon's south pole. These are basically cracks and ridges in Enceladus's ice. And it may also, similar to Europa, have a hydrothermal activity on the ocean floor, as on Earth there are vents in the ocean crust. Another of Saturn's moons, Saturn's largest moon, Titan, is not likely to have an ocean under ice, though there is ice spotted on the surface of this moon. Life here is very debatable because it's far too cold for liquid water, though the ice could be melted into liquid water, and there's also methane found on its surface. And methane is a byproduct of some forms of life. The Cassini spacecraft reached Titan and Saturn in 2004. There are two parts to this spacecraft, the Huygens probe and the Cassini orbiter. The Huygens probe descended onto Titan's surface through its murky atmosphere. And Titan's atmosphere is murky because there are many clouds and it is very dense. The Cassini orbiter is still orbiting Saturn and studying its moons. Another spacecraft is the Kepler Space Observatory. This spacecraft was launched by NASA to discover portions of the Milky Way for Earth-like planets specifically. It was named after Johannes Kepler, an astronomer from the Renaissance period who studied planets eclipsing host stars. Based off of the way he studied these planets, it later led to scientists figuring out how to find other planets in our galaxy. There are many stars that have planets orbiting them, similar to ours. An example of this is Kepler-186f, an Earth-sized planet found in the habitable zone of its host star. This means that it receives the right amount of heat for life. It is only 10% larger than Earth, receives about 1/3 of the energy Earth receives, and is likely to be rocky. So if you're on this planet at high noon, it receives about as much light as on Earth an hour before sunset, and is about 500 light years away. So that's pretty far, because one light year is equal to 5.88 trillion miles. Though maybe we can find a way to travel there within not ordinary spacecraft. And there are even four other planets in its solar system. Kepler-62f, another of these planets, is also very similar to Earth, though it's 40% larger. There are billions of stars in our galaxy and billions of galaxies in the universe. And many of these stars have planets orbiting them, and many of these planets may have possible life on them. So maybe some of these planets we can find life on. So we need to look for a new home and extraterrestrial life. Organizations like NASA already started the search for life and new home. And we must continue that search because we have already found possible life on moons and planets. So we have just started the search for a new planet, and Earth will be gone before you expect it. So we need to be prepared to leave. Thanks for listening.